Welcome to a new H&M haul with a twist. So I did one of these a few weeks ago and the response I got was so overwhelming and I was really, really grateful for the messages I received about the style of video. So I thought it would be a really good idea to do one for this transitional, it's not quite the new season, but we're going into the new season, we're not buying summer stuff anymore. And I think it's always good to think a little bit ahead and pre-plan. And I find that this time is a really great time of year, this kind of in-between transitional period, to kind of reset your wardrobe, go back to basics, really focus on those core pieces and get those strong in your wardrobe. So I wanted to do that with an H&M focus. So if you didn't see the last one of these hauls, basically, it was rather than me going out, purchasing lots and lots of items that I don't need, possibly returning some. It just feels so wasteful. It doesn't feel right to me or my channel. It's a waste of time, hassle and money, and I don't think it's necessary to show you what's new in the shops. So I thought instead what I'd do is do a haul, but just instead of showing you what I've bought, show you what I think is a good buy for you maybe. And the way I'm gonna do that is just by showing you pictures. I'll be linking everything below. And what somebody suggested last time, which I thought was really good, is that if I have a similar item already in my wardrobe, maybe show pictures or videos of how I've styled that in the past and why I think it would be useful to you and kind of show you my rendition of that. So it's not gonna be necessarily the exact same item, but something I think ticks a similar box. And I might try and do that with some of the pieces, because some of the pieces here are possibly things I have similar versions of, which is another reason why I wouldn't want to go out and buy loads of new pieces, because I already own quite a lot of these pieces. They're very much staple items. So I personally don't need them, but I really think they're key in building up your wardrobe. So I hope that makes sense as to why I'm doing it in this format. I know last time a lot of you really liked it, so hopefully this one will be as much appreciated. So let's get into the first item. So I will mention that this is currently all in the new in section in H&M, so hopefully it will be available where you are. I think if you click on the link, I can only produce UK links, but I think if you click on the link where you are, it should automatically redirect you. But if not, you should be able to see the item code maybe if you click on the link anyway. But the first item is this ribbed knit dress. And the reason why I like this is because it's not too tight. I don't love really tight knitted dresses because I don't think they're uber flattering, and I think sometimes when you're wearing maybe a chunkier boot or oversized coat, a really, really tight knit dress just doesn't feel quite right with that kind of style. So I picked this for this slouchy fit. I love the long sleeves. The V-neck is nice because you can kind of wear it as it is or kind of layer it with maybe a white t-shirt underneath, so just to kind of mix it up and add a different dimension to it. As I always mention, you should really look out for those small details that make something look a lot more expensive than it is. And in this case, I would say it's this gorgeous beige marle color. It's the side split up the side and the slight puff sleeve that it's got going on. It's those small bits of attention to detail that I think make something look a lot more elevated. And I think this would look great with a pair of boots, some chunky loafers, trainers for when it's a little bit warmer, going through that transitional season again. And also I think these kind of dresses look so nice in the evening with a strappy heel, big earrings, red lipstick, and it really dresses them up. So I think this would be a very versatile piece and also one I think that would work so well for all age groups too. So my next piece is this double-breasted coat. This is a really, really affordable coat. And I love this dogtooth pattern. It's a timeless pattern. If you go back to the 1950s, you'll see those old Hollywood film stars wearing the dog's tooth. So it really is a timeless print for the new season that, you know, will never date. But I love this slightly cocoon, oversized style. And often in the autumn, winter, we only see the coat. We don't really see what's underneath. If you're out and about, your coat is your central piece to your outfit. So I think it's really nice to have maybe a plain option in your wardrobe, but to have something a little bit different, like the check, that will still go with lots of things. And I really like wearing this kind of dog's tooth with lighter denim, especially going into the kind of autumn season where it's not really cold yet. I could see this coat, almost acting as a blazer with a white t-shirt and some wide slouchy denim, but then going through to the winter season, it's very oversized, so you can really layer this up, get lots of chunky knitwear underneath there. So I think that would be a really, really good purchase because it's stylish without being over the top, kind of fashion forward in your face. It's very, very wearable at the same time. Okay, let's talk about this rib knit jumper. I feel like this will sell out so quickly. So if you are interested, get there fast. But I do have a couple of variations of this style of jumper, and I have had so many questions whenever I've worn this style. And I think it's a really, really good piece to have in your wardrobe. This kind of slightly sweetheart neckline and the wider shoulders, they make such useful pieces for when you don't want to really dress up in maybe a dress or a blouse or something like that, but you want to add a bit of glam to it. So for example, I actually had one from Naked Fashion. It's years old now, but last winter we went to the Lake District and we were going out in the evening. I didn't want to look too dressy because it's quite casual there, but I also wanted something a little bit elevated, and I had a knit a bit similar to this, and they look great just dressed up with some leather trousers and some nice earrings, or alternatively jeans. You could wear them with a satin midi skirt. So they're a really useful piece to dress up and down, wear in the evening and not look too done and over the top. And I just think this version is a really great fit and cut. I've gone for the cream one in my basket, but they do have other shades of this. And I also think it's so nice to have a knit in your wardrobe that isn't a really oversized knit, one that you can tuck in. It's something that I think a lot of us maybe don't consider, but it's actually really useful. So boots are one of those things that you should be buying now because they sell out ridiculously fast, and I find that sometimes they're sold out nearly all season. Even if they come back in stock, they'll get sold out straight away. So I think if you are thinking about a new boot purchase, go for these straight away. So I've got these high knee leather boots. These are so timeless, and I actually have a pair from about maybe 3 years ago, from maybe more actually, from Zara. I'll try and see if I've got some pictures. I'm sure I have. And every time I wear them, I get so many questions about them, but because they're slightly older, I can't link them. So now is my chance to link a really good alternative. You can't go wrong with a knee-high boot, especially one that's not too clingy to the leg. It goes with absolutely everything. You can tuck them into slouchy trousers. You can wear them with dresses, with skirts. They're just one of those things that I think everyone needs in their wardrobe, and you'll just find that you'll constantly wear them throughout autumn, winter. So my next piece is just this casual lounge set. And I love this because it's like the autumn version of those plissé two sets that have been everywhere for the past year. If you don't know what I mean, the plissé is that very, very kind of finely concertinaed looking fabric, and a lot of them come in like a two-piece set. I've got one from Under the Stories, but the thing with the plissé is that it does look quite dressy, whereas this version just feels so cool and relaxed. Really nice one to wear at home. I think a lot of us maybe neglect our homeware and what we wear around the house, but this is a really affordable way to feel chic at home. And I think I talk about this a lot, but style for me is living an overall stylish life, whether that's kind of your interiors, what you wear around the house, to how you go out and present yourself. So it really, I think style should encompass your all aspects of your life. And by feeling nice and chic and put together at home, I just think you feel better mentally as well. So to wear something nice like this two-piece set is a really great one. You can just throw it on with some trainers and a smart blazer and you're good to pop out of the house. So H&M are the go-to for straight leg trousers. I feel like they always do, actually not just straight legs, wide legs too, they always do a really great version of a straight leg trouser. And straight leg trousers are so, so useful, especially this pair. So it's the ankle length trousers, but what I love about these is on the model they look quite slouchy, but not too slouchy. They really tick that box between not being kind of a very straight clingy leg, but something a little bit looser, more relaxed, more modern, something you can really dress up and down. This is an all-rounder trouser for me, one you can wear for the office with some loafers, smart shoes, ballet flats. You can wear for the weekend with trainers, You can put it with a pair of heels. You can add any kind of top to it, slouchy knitwear, t-shirts, blouses, blazers. So a real all-rounder pair of trousers. And this color is called green beige, which is actually like my favorite tone of beige. I just think it feels so modern but timeless at the same time, and very, very versatile as well. And also they've got an elasticated waist at the back but still got belt holes, so they're really, really comfortable, but you can still wear them with a belt, which is just win-win. I always find when I do these roundups that I kind of convince myself that I need to buy something, but yeah, I need to rein it in a little bit. But anyway, my next piece is this quilted jacket. Really, really useful one. I think we often neglect these pieces that are a bit more casual. Maybe we'll just go for a smart coat, but I think it's nice to have a really nice in-between, something that's not too heavy, like a big puffer coat, something relaxed, and this quilted jacket definitely does this. It also comes in black, so if you're not a green person, you could go for the black version, but you can just, like the models doing, throw it on with a pair of jeans. You could even wear it with joggers. You could wear it with that the kind of ribbed knit set that I showed you before, kind of casually. You could dress it up with some smart trousers, but it's just a really useful one to throw on, especially if you go on dog walks like me, to have that kind of lightweight jacket for those warmer autumn days, but still just kind of keeps you a little bit covered. So next piece I absolutely adore, which is a bit more of an elevated jacket. So this is a wool blend jacket. You can tell that it looks a lot more premium. It is a bit more expensive for H&M, but kind of still affordable in the kind of whole jacket spectrum, especially a smart wool blend jacket like this. And I love this cream color, the neckline, it's just so chic. And I think if you've got a smart office job where you don't always want to wear a blazer, this would be a great option. I think you can keep this on. It's not necessarily a coat, it is more of a jacket. But for, like I say, autumn's not always cold. So to have more of a jacket rather than a big coat is a really nice option. And I love these cream jackety coats with denim to really dress it down. Love that contrast of the smart, elegant, ladylike coat with some denim. It just makes such a good combination. But also with leather trousers, I think this would look great with. It's one of those that you can pop with everything, but I think it's a really, really smart jacket to have. And I love this rounded neckline too. So next on my list is this knitted jumper. This is really affordable. It's $19.99. I'd perhaps go up a size in this. I like a bit more of a slouchier knit in this kind of shape, round neck. And that's actually something that I really want to invest in my wardrobe, because each time I always pick up one that I've got from Philippa K. It's a beautiful cashmere one, and I absolutely adore it. It's like my favorite jumper in my wardrobe, but it's like a kind of taupey gray, and sometimes I want more of a cream version of that. So I think this would make a really nice alternative if I wanted that lighter color. But it also comes in a really nice brown, and it also comes in pink if you want a pop of color. But I think this is a really nice fit, shape, very elegant, very simple, and a really nice piece of knitwear that's not too heavy to take you through nicely to that transitional season and period. Okay, I'm obsessed with this shirt. This is called a pointed collar shirt. Actually, they do it in a really nice cream one as well, but my favorite is this striped version. It's like a black and white stripe, and I'm seeing a lot of this around at the moment. I think Arquette have done a similar one, and I'm sure I've seen one somewhere else, this kind of black and white stripe. I think it's so chic, and I feel like it just gives a really clean, crisp look whilst adding something extra to your outfit. With it being a stripe, you can keep the rest of your outfit really, really simple, and the stripe does the talking. I think with some good earrings, this shirt just really pops and stands out, but it also looks great in the cream I think it's like an off-white, if you're looking for that kind of shirt. But to me, it just looks so much more expensive than it is, and also a really wearable piece too. So talking about knitwear, this wool blend cardigan is probably one of the top of my list of favorites of this haul that I'm doing. I love this shape, this boxier shape, this color. I think it looks expensive. I think it's very, very wearable with everything. I love cardigans. You can just pop them over your shoulders when it's quite warm outside, like now it's the end of August, beginning of September. It's still warm outside, but sometimes you just want that extra layering piece. Even with a dress, I actually had a really nice white summer dress on the other day from my collection with Pretty Lavish, and I just took a cardigan with me and popped that on for when it got a little bit cooler. So they're really useful pieces, not just for autumn, winter, but also for warmer days too, just as a little bit of an extra layer. Again, I think that I would size up in this, but there are so many ways to wear it, and I just think a real staple piece in your transitional wardrobe. So next is this cutout body. Again, a really useful piece for dressing up, but not too dressy. I just love these little bits of cutouts here. And I personally love to wear wide leg trousers in the evening or wide leg jeans. And I could see this looking so good with some wide leg white trousers. Again, for more transitional dressing, but then through to the cooler months with black wide leg trousers, a great belt or some good earrings. And I just think it's a real staple to have in your wardrobe. I think you know already that I'm not somebody who goes out and buys really dressy over the top party pieces, but I like to kind of play it a bit more low key and dress things up with accessories. And I think this would make a really good one to have in your wardrobe. When you do have an occasion to go to, you can just pull it out and pair it with different things to dress it up or down. So these slim fit high ankle jeans are next on my list because I think everyone needs a pair of good slim leg, but not too baggy, not too skinny jeans in their wardrobe. And I think this is a really, really solid pair and shape. And I love that they feel quite smart. They're not too light washed. They're not got cuts or rips or frays on them. And I think it's good to have that kind of shape that feels a bit more like a smart denim. I love them with a kitten heel, strappy high heels with flats, loafers, ballet flats. Boots as well, they'll look really good with going forward, like an ankle boot, blazers and long coats, but they're just a real staple, good shape of denim, and $19.99 as well, so affordable. So I added this next top in because I think it had real kind of taupe slash Kate vibes with the ruched body detail. It's off the shoulder, very, very simple and easy to wear. It's a bit like the cutout one, but if you wanted something maybe not with the long sleeves and high neck, a little bit more of an alternative, I think this ruched top would look so good with some wide legs as well. Very, very chic and easy to wear, but at the same time, just looks something a little bit different. It's still classic, a little bit glamorous, and I could see this with a pair of earrings. These are from Zara, by the way, but nice pair of earrings like this in the evening. Just, yeah, I think that would look so good. So my final piece is a little bit of cashmere. So obviously a little bit more expensive with it being cashmere, but I think if you are kind of looking for a really luxurious piece on a bit more of a budget, then look to these high street brands because a lot of them do tend to do cashmere. It obviously will be more expensive than their mainstream range, but less expensive than if you go to a mid-range or designer brand for cashmere. So this is a cashmere and wool mix jumper. It's $99.99. So not crazy expensive, but just a really nice mix of two great fabrics. So I love this navy style, slouchy, big chunky neck. I think this will never ever date. This feels so elegant to me. I think with a simple pair of jeans would look so good. I think it's one of those pieces you'll need in your wardrobe. Navy in the autumn, winter. A navy at any time of year is very, very classic and chic, but I think in the autumn, winter, it's something to think about as an alternative to black, but I love the pairing of navy and black together. You could be wearing this with some leather trousers. I think would look so great. Awesome jeans, like I say. And I think even in the evening, you could wear this with some silk trousers to dress it up, some good earrings. I think this will come in very handy. And I think to work as well with a nice smart pair of trousers would work very, very well. So something to think about if you're looking for a little bit more of a luxe fabric on the high street. So thank you so much for watching. I hope this video has been useful for you. If it has, please let me know in the comments. Let me know what other brands you'd like to see. Obviously, H&M always goes down really well, but any other brands you'd like to see, let me know. I know a lot of you are in the US as well, so please let me know some brands that are maybe more global. I know you don't have Arquette over there yet. Maybe, I think you've got COS and other stories. So do let me know if there's any other brands you'd like to see. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget, subscribe if you are enjoying my videos, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.